The following is brought to you by TruthTimeRadio.com.
A listener writes, I was recently at a Bible study where a debate took place concerning the mark of Cain. Someone there said it had something to do with Cain's skin color. If you would be so kind to please provide me with any information you have that may be helpful. Alright, let's look at Genesis 4:15. And the Lord said unto him, Therefore, whosoever slayeth Cain, vengeance shall be taken on him sevenfold. And the Lord set a mark upon Cain, lest any finding him should kill him. What was the mark of Cain? Well, this has been a troublesome question to many for hundreds of years. Some have speculated on the mark of Cain, and, there's no need for speculation. Just believe the Bible. Let's just compare Scripture with Scripture and let it say what it says and mean just that. Leviticus 19, verse 28. Ye shall not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead, nor print any marks upon you. I am the Lord. Now, there's those same two words. Mark upon. Mark upon. From this, are we to think that God is telling them to not change their skin color? He says, don't make any marks upon you. And folks for hundreds of years have said that that means Cain's skin color was changed. That's ludicrous. It only stands to reason that if the Lord put a mark on Cain to keep him alive, as we just read in Genesis 4:15, that he would make a law that states, you shall not make any marks upon you. Why? Because if everyone else were free to print marks upon their body, then there would no longer be a distinction made between them and Cain. So it's clear here that the mark of Cain had nothing to do with skin color. God did not turn Cain's skin white like he did Moses in Exodus 4:6, or like he did Naaman in 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 1, or like he did Elisha's servant Gehazi in verse 27 of the same chapter. No, this is clearly a mark upon the skin, and had nothing to do with changing the color of the skin. Mark upon, not color, mark upon. In our Bible, we can find many other references where God changed skin color, as it happened to Jeroboam, king of Israel, in 2 Kings 15:5. It happened to King Uzziah in 2 Chronicles 26:21. It happened to Simon in Matthew 26:6. You know, there are those who act as though God had a communication problem and was not capable of being a clear articulator. Hey, if God told us when he changed the skin color of Moses, and told us when he changed the skin color of Naaman, if he told us when he did the same thing to Naaman's servant and many others throughout the Bible, then please explain to me why anyone would think that the mark of Cain is referring to skin color. God, just like he did so many other times in the Bible, would have simply said he changed the color of Cain's skin. So if the mark of Cain would have had anything to do with skin color, God would have simply said so.
Galatians 4:16. Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth? For more answers to your Bible questions, stop by TruthTimeRadio.com.